For the last 10 years, I've been painting a Jackson 5 portrait every year. And they haven't aged. It's like they still look the same over the last 10 years. And I like to communicate through visuals as well as sound. Hi, I'm Terry Hall from The Specials. You're watching Real Talk on YouDiscover. We don't class ourselves necessarily as a ska band. Our influences are definitely ska and reggae, but they're also punk rock and, you know, the Beatles. We soak everything up. And with our first album, the idea was to take all these influences and try to unite it into our sound, and which we did. But even at that point, we sort of slightly moved on from ska and reggae. But it's down to the rhythm, and it's down to a very, very basic language, really, which is music. And I don't think in terms of genres or styles. It's like, this music is what we grew up with and what we know. And it works, really. But what we want to do is play a lot of gigs, because we really enjoy playing gigs. And now we've got the new album, it makes it, for us, even more exciting, because we can explore musically with new songs, and that's great. And all of a sudden, we've got a huge amount of songs to fit into one gig. But I really like the idea of this year being a huge celebration of what we do and what we are for us. And well, the idea of making another record didn't become apparent until maybe 2 years ago, where we knew we had a 40th anniversary, and we knew that we would play a lot of dates. So we also felt like we wanted new material, and had the choice, really, of either doing cover versions or writing our own material. And we got in the studio and we started again. But it was pretty straightforward, pretty easy. Encore isn't a finality. Encore is a repeat. And it's a request for more. Because I was very careful to look at this in the dictionary to get the true definition. And it's a request, it's a popular demand for more music or another performance. And in the last 10 years, a lot of people have said, why don't you make another record? I mean, we play gigs every year, but we haven't given an encore on vinyl yet. And that's what it is. But you know, we never think about long term. It's just pointless. You know, like the death of Brad is a great example of that, where we had a year planned out, and then he had a heart attack. So it's at our age, it's pointless looking too far ahead. We're just happy to get up in the morning and see what the day brings. So we were all ready to think about recording, and we'd sort of laid plans in that summer 4 years ago, but then John passed away, and it was a total shock because it came out of nowhere. It was a sudden death, and there was no illness leading up to it. So it left us in shock for months, and it was only maybe a year after that we thought we still want to carry on, and you know, in his name as well. And it was a huge blow, and personally, and we didn't even think about the band. It was like, personally, we'd lost a really good friend. But it's good, you know, time moves on, and you get on with what you gotta do. The new drummer is somebody called Kenrick Rowe. He's very steady, and he's a very accomplished musician. And he's done hundreds and hundreds of gigs. And he fits in straight away. There are no teething problems. He's just very, very good at what he does. We have been known as a political band for 40 years, and things don't really change. Faces change and situations change, but there are really basic underlying problems with any society, and that's poverty, and that's work, and racism. They're the same sort of deal, and we find ourselves now performing again in pretty troubled times, I think, and you know, especially in the UK, in the last 2 years, people have become are becoming really disillusioned again. And as for anywhere else around the world, it's very difficult to comment on Donald Trump because it's too surreal. It's like, I still don't take it seriously. And he definitely doesn't take it seriously. The world is the world, man. It's like, thank you.